Godot's control nodes have a confusing way of being positioned, but once you get to understand it, it's actually pretty great. Let's start off by making a user interface scene. In Godot, control nodes are just another word for user interface nodes. Next, let's add a button to the control node. Its margin properties each represent a distance in pixels relative to the top left corner of the button. What that means is, if you increase the right margin to 50, then the right side of the button extends 50 pixels out from the top left corner. If you decrease the top value to negative 50, then the top of the button extends upwards 50 pixels from the top left corner, because negative y values actually mean upwards in Godot. Notice how the top left corner marker is unaffected by adjusting the margins. I'm tired of having the button in the top left corner, so let's move it. Not like that. That's not the proper way. So let's reset all the margin values to zero. The anchor values determine how the node should fit within the parent control node. So if you set the right anchor all the way to 1, then the button will go as far right as the parent control node does. You can then adjust the parent control node's right anchor or margin. Look at that, the button adjusts with it. If you set the parent control node back all the way right and all the way down, and then you do the same with the button will fill the entire screen. Now, to make the button 100 pixels smaller in each direction than the parent control node, all you have to do is adjust the button's margins like this. So, to recap, the anchor property is relative to the parent, while the margin property adjusts a specific amount of pixels. If you enjoyed the video, then please leave a like.